All right. Ooh, my mic works. All right. Hey, everybody. My name is Mike Darby. I hail from Dell headquarters in Round Rock, Texas. And we're going to do some platform and infrastructure announcements today. So what we're about to announce pulls heavily from the Open Compute Project. And so I want to take a moment to shout out to a lot of people who I just was standing with. One of them is over there, whose names are on this slide, who do a lot of work with OCP. So whether it's the server project or under the server project, all of these work streams, DCMHS, HPM, MCRPS, DCSCM, Emily Clark on the Coldplay project, and the work that John Lewis and Jason Rock have done on OCP NIC. There is a ton of work being done, and these guys have been walking around the halls delivering better speeches than mine throughout this conference. I was with a very large customer about 2 weeks ago in the executive briefing center down in Round Rock, and he told me that one of Dell's superpowers is all of this standards-based work we do, and not all of it is on this slide. We do work with Redfish, with DMTF. There's people who do PCIe SIG stuff, and stuff beyond that that I don't even understand. So when I started in Poweredge in 2017, we were just launching the 14th generation of Poweredge. And at the time, there were three servers that had something derived from OCP, and it was just the OCP2 NIC. And so now, flash forward to today, we're launching the 17th generation of PowerEdge, and we have DCMHS HPMs, we have MCRPS power supplies, and we have IDRAC, our systems management, living on a DCSCM. And so it's very much open standards based at PowerEdge. And so that is the lead into the product announcements we're going to have. So let me first tell you the challenges we're facing with our partner roadmaps that are leading us to do the next big leap in OCP adoption. So the theme of the conference, performance leaps in dense compute and AI. This is truly a paradigm shifting and server design breaking and rack design breaking and building new data centers is all being driven by the leaps and bounds being done by our partners who are at this conference. So when you think about just thinking about the last generation of servers and, a 700-watt GPU times 8 in a server, we have 3,000-watt power supplies in that server. And you heard Forrest Norad talking about what the future looks like. He mentioned he uttered 2,000-watt in his speech, in his keynote. And, if you think about in the halls of Dell, Round Rock 5, putting that onto a graph, the graph of power of, all the GPUs and CPUs going, it turns into a hockey stick pretty quick. And so to deal with that hockey stick, we need to have new infrastructure that, integrates liquid cooling as not as an afterthought, but as a forethought. We need to rethink the design of our servers to accommodate the growing sizes of chips and the growing power. And we need to have the deployment services that are capable of delivering these solutions to allow customers to generate value quicker. So, the products we're revealing today, starting with our new OCP-derived scalable rack infrastructure, the integrated rack 7000. So this is born on top of ORV3 open rack, and we'll get into the details on the next slide, but the next two platforms listed on this slide are going to go into that rack infrastructure. The PowerEdge M7725 is AMD EPYC fifth generation based. It's our dense compute Turin platform. And after that, the PowerEdge XE9712 is our compute node for our partnership with NVIDIA, bringing GB200 NVL72 to market. So, and underlying all of this is expanded rack integration and deployment services to get it all to the customer as fast as possible. So starting with the integrated rack 7000, it looks familiar because it's based on ORV3. Dell, standing on the shoulders of the great work done by the Rack and Power Group that drove that standard. Dell has taken it and done some engineering on top of it for scalability, serviceability, and future-proof. Because as you can see on the slide, we don't want to just build this for this generation of servers that we're going to be launching today and then the coming months going into this rack, but for years into the future. And as you can see on the slide, I have 480 kilowatts written down. The future-proof design of what's gone into this rack, not only from the power elements and the cooling elements, but for the serviceability of the density and cabling and all that needed to get to 480 kilowatts is designed into this rack already. And so without further ado, I'm going to tell you the first platform that we're launching into it. Before I do that, note that we have 44 OU and 50 OU listed on this slide. So an OU, if you're not familiar with an ORV3 rack, is about 3 millimeters taller than a rack U from a 19-inch world and about 3 inches wider. Okay. So when we go to 50 OU, it is a very tall rack indeed, and that'll be relevant for something I'm going to say on the next slide. So those of you with keen eyes, when you looked at the Poweredge M7725, would have seen that this, what looks like one server here, is actually an enclosure with two servers in it. This is a dense two-node enclosure with two M7725s in it. So two-socket AMD fifth-generation EPYC, you know, Turin processors, up to 192 cores, 500 watts each CPU. Now, if we take that 50 OU rack that we're making, and we put as many of these half-width nodes as we can fit into a rack, with accounting for in-rack high-speed interconnect and top-of-rack networking and power shelves that you have to make it work, we're left with about 72 half-width nodes of 192 cores each. And if you add that up together, you're at about 27,000 cores in a single rack of Turin. So we are super excited about that. If you look at the front of this of the dual nodes on the far left there, lower left, you can see that little glowing blue power button sitting on the iDRAC DCSCM module derived from OCP. Right next to it is the OCP slot, OCP 3.0 derived from here as well, and inside is a DCSCM HPM. So on top of that, it features two high-speed Gen 5 by 16 slots and Gen 5 NVMe storage. I'm going to keep going since I'm in between you and the party in the hallway. So this one's near and dear to my heart. This is the one that I have been working on with many of the engineers that were listed on that first slide who are in the back of the room taking pictures right now. The Poweredge XE9712 is Dell's server node going into the IR7000 rack to partner with NVIDIA to bring the GB200 NVL72 to market. Now, we heard Ian Buck's keynote as well talking about the 1.8 terabytes of NVLink between the GPUs, so that 72 GPUs in a rack can act as one and deliver that 30x inferencing performance that they're talking about. And that's important, but the customers buying this, most of them are buying it at scale. And so just as important as that 1.8 terabytes in the rack is scaling it with the optimal networking architecture for east-west GPU traffic and for north-south storage traffic. And you know, on top of the enhanced rack integration services that this is going to require, the logistics of delivery to get the thing to you on time and powered up and validated on both ends of that shipment, Dell is here to deploy, design and deploy that entire end-to-end solution, inclusive of the network, you know, cabled and labeled on site. So with that comes, you know, building on our 15 years of rack scale, rack integration and deployment services. Now that we have this new rack infrastructure that is tailored for rack scale, truly it becomes the primary sales motion for these servers and for this infrastructure, as opposed to one way to get something that you could otherwise buy in cardboard boxes individually. So, you know, this is going to start with a comprehensive assessment of your data center, going through build, you know, configure, validation, shipment, the logistics of shipment, making sure there's a ramp in the right place where it needs to be to get it in the room, making sure the door's not too low in the data center you think you're putting it into, making sure you have the power, making sure the power whips match the power you have, all of those fun things. And when it gets on site and it gets deployed and it gets cabled and labeled at scale, that it's validated again, not just before it leaves, but after it leaves and before Dell leaves your site. And after all that, you have one throat to choke, one partner to call if anything breaks, because we did the whole thing. And you know, adding that on top of it kind of brings the solution together and allows us to deliver the value and get the customer generating, you know, value out of their investment quicker. So with that, thank you guys very much, and I'll turn you loose on the beers in the hallway. Thank you so much.